communities are doing with education and jobs, companies starting up in small places and...
What's that, right?
The Smart Communities Seminar webinar yesterday.
Oh, did you go?
Well, I went to my dad's.
Yeah, actually. Did your mind go there?
Yes, it was good. Enlightening.
As part of the strategic plan for this year, there's making an application to the Smart Communities program, I guess. I'm not quite sure who's going to be taking that on, but it's ideal.
What's the project you're applying for?
The project has to be decided yet.
Just decided to apply. Yeah, there's a lot of funding out there. I mean, County Council has quite a lot right now, BC Arts Council. And what they really are looking for, those ones anyway, are partnering. So different, like within the community, there's a bunch of...
Sort of a private public, yeah.
Yeah, and so, and we can even do like a conference here. You could do like a digital conference and have a whole bunch of different speakers. Like they would fund something like that. And so it's not about, you know, we can partner and bring in different money, but...
Could our internet handle that right now? Well, that's the funny thing, is that these little communities have broadband internet, and we're sitting beside that city and don't have it.
It's the water in between.
Yeah.
That's the issue.
We're too close.
And the topography here. So a lot of those little communities that have super good community broadband are flat.
Right.
And it's dead easy. There's no water to cross to get to them.
Wave wireless things across, yeah. Anyway, the summer was just about that.
It wasn't, yeah.
There was really nothing else discussed, but you have to go digital, which was kind of interesting. I heard one, somebody threw an agri tourism as a one line, and that was it. They had different communities talking about their situation. Granite, Nelson, Olds, Alberta, which I think is... created a lot of jobs from bringing in broadband.
And are they talking about like micro businesses benefiting, or are they
talking
about...
Yes, that and education centers, yes. So some of them, it seems, have revived their whole community.
And right.
New technologies, like really concentrated, like, and that people get inspired because they have those tools now that they're able to do, so they can work from a center. Right.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Research is so much.
Yeah, they did quite a bit on that, you know, the, you know, manufacturing automobiles, how the number of employees in those are like a tenth of what they used to be because of automation. So the only growth is in this digital telecommuting and jobs that and that in the next 20 years, they estimate 1 billion jobs created in that area. So, which means, again, a lot more people working at home. I think Google has something that they will train you to be a Google tech or something, so you can stay at home. So anyway, they're getting jobs like that, and without having to leave their little spot.
It's 22, Mike. Should we start?
Yes, please.